Hello, welcome, good afternoon to a further webinar with the topic ABB iBus KNX Switch Actuators ETS Application Version 1.1. My name is Thorsten Reibel from the Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings. Yeah, I will present today around 1 hour. What is planned for today? The topic is KNX Switch Actuators, the new application. So I give you first of all a short overview about the existing Switch Actuator range from ABB. I come to the overview of the existing ETS application 1.0, and then of course we talk about the new features in the ETS application version 1.1. Yeah, there's also a firmware update just available, and I would like to talk about this as well. And this application update you have to do, or you have to know about it, can be supported by an app called Update Copy Convert app. So I will talk about this app as well. Also about this firmware app, update app. These are two apps I would like to show a bit. And last but not least, I come to the topic bus coupler key, a function in the ETS, which is also supported by our switch actuators right now. So let's have a look to the existing switch actuators. We started around 2 years ago with the combi switch actuators, the market launch. Two components in total, with two applications behind, not only switching, but also shutter functionality is possible. So two outputs from the switch actuator can be programmed as a shutter output to run any motor. Very nice keypad is integrated for manual operation. And yeah, this product is typically made for residential projects. Then we have our standard switch actuators, 12 in total. Typically made for commercial project for the standard application. And additionally, we have the so-called professional switch actuators. We launched beginning of last year, and the combination with energy functions also last year at the end. And these professional switch actuators have a high switching capacity, so the best relays inside. And the components with energy functions, I come to this later, additional nice features because there's also a current measurement per output available. Let's have a small look to the components you see here on the left. The components of this combi switch actuator from the combi switch actuator family. You see the keypad here, very nice keypad to operate each output individually. Available with 6, 10 and 16 ampere and up to 24 channels, 8, 16 and 24 channels. So in one 12 module width device, you have up to 24 channels or 12 shutter channels, for example. But you can mix all the channels as you want. So in total, 9 devices. Then we have the standard switch actuator. Look typically as also our older devices with a relay available via the lever. With a screwdriver, you can operate it manually. Also 6, 10 and 16 ampere available with up to 12 channels, but also 2 channels here. And in total 12 devices. And here the professional switch actuators. You remember with the high capacity load relays, C load means high inrush currents can be handled. Only one relay with 4 different number of channels. But if you use the component with energy function, it's another hardware. With current measurement, you have an additional 4 components. Yeah, so combi switch actuators typically for residential projects, the others more for commercial, but practically you are free to use it in any kind of projects. So let's have a look to the ETS application, the actual version 1.0. It's a market launch. Boston is still a very comprehensive ETS application. It's very, I think, satisfying user experience. Let's have a short look to the main features inside. We have the so-called templates for switch and shutter functions. What does it mean? You can create a template for a collection of parameters. You can parameterize it and assign these templates then later to individual outputs if you want. So you don't have to parameterize each output individually. You can use this template. You don't have to do it. You can also say, no, this output needs individual parameterization, but very useful to save time during parameterization. Then a comprehensive logic is integrated with different typical gates or logic blocks and or exclusive or gate. completely individually programmable, so also independent of the outputs. Here we have some news. I come to this a bit later in more details. The combi switch actuator with the shutter functionality has all the functions or parameters you need for shutter functions. So full functionality, also these safety and weather alarms, integrated automatic sun protection. So in case of strong sun on the facade, you can run down or move down the blinds automatically. You can integrate it into scenes. You can block a shutter output so nobody can operate it due to any security reasons. You can bring it into a forced position, let's say, up, down, or in a middle position. All these things are available. The only thing we do not have, you might remember from some other standard shutter actuator, is a travel time detection. The switch outputs have these typical time function staircase, delay flashing. You remember this safety priority. Also here some news. I come to this as well later. Also forced operation on or off so that nobody can operate it locally anymore. You can block completely an output and integrate it in our one byte scenes, 16 in total. Very nice also these central objects for the main functions, switching, shutter, and scenes. Means if you would like to operate more or less all channels in a device, or maybe only selected, but many, you don't have to add to each group object individual, or the same group address. You can take the central object and then only one group address has to be assigned, and all assigned outputs will be operated then in this case. If needed, we have always these blue colored hints within the parameterization to give you a hint when anything else has to be done. And switch actuators with energy functions. Practically, there is real current measurement behind. And if you assume that you have a constant voltage, you can do normally, we can calculate the power, the energy consumption. We can assign different outputs to so-called energy groups to get for all these assigned loads the total energy, for example. Load monitoring is possible, allows you to get information in which load level the load is right now. Is it underload, overload, is it maximum load? Can be directly then monitored. Load shedding, also here's something new. I will explain it a bit later. And the so-called contact status supervision means I can monitor the contact this way that I know the status from the communication, but know where the current detection also is there a real current flowing. And of course, if the contact should be closed but no current, then there's something wrong with the circuit, with the load, maybe the circuit breaker. So a real monitoring of the installation behind or the load. So this still exists, of course, with the new version 1.1, but has been adapted a bit, has been completed a bit. It's for ETS5 and ETS6, the application. So we have done, after the market launch, beginning of the market launch 2 years ago, a lot of webinars and online learning sessions around our switch actuators. Have a look here. I have given you here all these sessions we have done, including link to the video recording and also the presentation. So 3 webinars about the products itself and learning sessions about more details, ETS application, ETS programming, shutter functions, and of course also the energy functions and detail we have covered in these sessions. So have a look later if you need, all in our training qualification database available. But I think you are interested in the news of the ETS application version 1.1. What did we do? Load shedding is something we have completed, let's say, in logic and threshold. Threshold belongs to the logic functions. We have also added something or changed something. Scenes and safety priority, different in parameterization, and so-called output names can be given now. Additionally, the wording has been adapted, so maybe the wording is a bit different compared with the version 1.0, but in functions they're not different. And of course, as always, some bug fixing will be done if you have any new ETS application. Later I come to some smaller details as well, but here more related to the programming in the ETS. Let's have a look to the details. I start with the load shedding. Before we come to the changes, a small update. What is load shedding at all? Practically, it's a prevention of electrical load peaks in a building due to limited power and installation availability or significant costs if you overshoot a certain power level. So our target is to turn off loads, different loads, with priority in order not to exceed a certain power level. And this is possible. This is so-called master. The master is the intelligence in this logic, which handles this. And the master can be our energy analyzer KNX, QAS 1161, or also a bit older device, energy actuator SES, also available some time already. And this can be the master. And this master receives from different loads the power value. Can be from any energy meter via our metering so interface module to the FB energy meter, ZSS. Can be from our energy module, can be from our switch actuator professional that can practically sense the power, or also from any other energy actuator. So from here I get the values. The master sums up the value, and with a priority object, one byte object, it sends our so-called shedding stages from 1 to 8 to turn off dedicated loads with the lowest priority, the first ones, and then step by step it can increase the turning off of further loads on with 8 different levels. So, and our new, not new, our existing switch actuators have now also the option to be integrated in this load shedding, to be turned off, of course, or maybe also turned on if the load shedding stage is released. But of course, we need the logic behind, and we need a relay to do so. How to measure then from this load the power? Not possible in these components, only in the switch actuator with energy function professional. So I have to measure anywhere else. And I give an example here. As our Dali Gateway Premium can do load shedding as well, since spring of this year, of course, you have to measure here the power via an external device, in my case, an energy meter, and then via ZSS, it will be sent to our master. The same can be done also for loads coming from the combi switch actuator or the standard switch actuator, no problem. So turning off, no problem here, but measurement then here via an additional device. But finally, also these loads connected to all our other switch actuators can be integrated in the load shedding solution. Yeah, beside DALI Gateway Premium as well. In the DALI Gateway Premium, you cannot turn off the lamp, you dim down to lower levels depending on the stage you have sent. So it's a one byte priority control object we have to send, which can be of course sent by the master, but also received by the kind of slaves. The energy analyzer QAS, the KNX energy analyzer QAS, has also a one bit object per stage to integrate also further actuators which cannot understand these one byte priority objects. This is still possible and gives you further options here. Let's have a look to the parameters. So I have here, for example, the switch or the combi switch actuator. So it's now in all the components available. You enable the function here under functions and at the output A, for example, and then you get a collection of these typical parameters you need to adjust this, and of course also these dedicated group objects to handle this load shedding solution. So what are the group objects? In principle, it's a one byte object, receive load shedding stage. It's a one byte object with a stage number which has to be turned off, and in the output you assign which shedding stage belongs to this output, in my case one. You can also change this shedding stage via telegram if you want. This one here, set load shedding stage, one byte as well. What shall happen in case of active load shedding stage? Typically off, of course, but you can decide also what happens if it revokes the load shedding stage. Then I can say no reaction or on again if you want. We can have a status message. Is load shedding active, yes or no? It's a one bit object in this output. And that's what you can adjust here. So this is the new here, the load shedding part under each output beside other parameter blocks. Also here we have done a learning session about switch actuator with energy functions in detail from November last year. Also here the link to the presentation and the video if you would like to have some more details. So let's summarize. We can integrate also all our other switch actuators, not only with energy functions, into load shedding. Yeah, finally here, the assignment of group addresses to the objects, or one group address in principle only, mainly here is shown. Here is my master. It has the object send load shedding stage, one byte priority control, information which state have to be switched on, off, and it goes to the central object here, also at the DALI gateway or here at our all our switch actuators. So receive load shedding stage, and here you can also get the feedback status on off. And yeah, so all these components can be integrated here in load shedding. So what else did we do? Logic, the topic logic. We have so-called 24 individual logic blocks in each switch actuator with two inputs and one output. You see here an example for a gate and or exclusive OR gate and also thresholds. You can take one logic, combine it with another logic, and many more, up to 24 in principle. And finally, the output of your logic, the result of your logic, can be either sent only to KNX to be processed anywhere else independent of the outputs, or it can be linked also internally to a real internal output. It's here in the parameters possible. Up to you, of course, both then as well possible. So sending out and processing it directly in the in one internal output. So this is not new. What did we do? We added one additional block. So beside all these others, AND OR, exclusive OR AND gate and threshold, we added so-called one bit inverter. So how to choose this? Very simple. You have here six parameters, each enabling up to four logic blocks. And then you decide what shall be selected here, which kind of logic. And you see now one bit inverter is integrated. Yeah, one bit inverter is not very complicated. It's a function in principle inverting a one bit signal from one to zero and vice versa. I have experienced that this is sometimes needed, sometimes more needed than expected, because any status telegram, for example, has to be inverted or has an inverted behavior to be processed and displayed, and I need a quick inverter anywhere. And you can choose here directly in the switch actuator. And as you know, it's really independent of the outputs, so this inverter works for any other functions than the integrated outputs. Yeah, parameterization is very simple. Of course, the result have to be enabled normally, and then you have two group objects. So connection is the input, and status results is then the output. So we added here the inverter, and regarding threshold function, yeah, what is a threshold function? Also very important to compare values. Yeah, for example, if the temperature is below 2 degrees outside, you would like to send out a frost alarm. Or if the brightness level in a big room, event room, is going down to a lower level, then you would like to turn on the light fixtures next to the exit to 100% additionally, for example. This was already existing. What did we do? We added further data points. Data points we especially need in our switch actuators with energy functions. So milliampere, ampere, watt, kilowatt, watt hour, and kilowatt hour. And so these data we can also process now in the threshold to compare something. For example, you would like to have an alarm if the motor current of a fan goes too low, yeah, and energy consumption reached a certain level, and you need a message then 1,000 kilowatt hours are consumed. Maybe you turn off this load as well in such a case. And it's not only a simple threshold, it's also with upper and lower threshold means hysteresis can be adjusted as well. So I think very useful, especially for all these electrical values, energy values we might process in KNX as well. So that's new as well. Then I mentioned parameterization, scenes, and so-called safety priority. What did we do here? First of all, what is safety priority? It's not so often used, but yeah, not completely new. In principle, there are three safety priority objects behind, 1, 2, 3. And these objects have a priority. 1 is the highest, 3 is the lowest priority. And with telegram coming on these objects, you can turn on, turn off the relay with highest priority. For example, if you have in case of a fire alarm, all lights should be turned on, but nobody should turn it off anymore. Then you do it with the highest priority and nobody can turn off locally anymore. And this telegram can be also monitored if it's sent cyclically. Just to monitor also such an important signal, you can also disable this here. Yeah, and this is not new as a function, but what is new is the way to parameterize this here in the ETS application. And now it's possible to use within the ETS parameter window so-called tables, a bit like an Excel sheet, let's say, where you can much easier and with a better overview parameterize functions. Maybe you remember this already from the DALI Gateway Premium, where we used this for scenes and also sequences, even more comprehensive parameterization. And there not only numbers have to be selected, but sometimes also out of a color field, you can pick the color, for example. Very nice to use, so makes it easier and more comfortable to parameterize. If you look to the scene, so the scene is neither anything new, but also only the parameterization has been adapted. You see we have 1, 2, 3, 6, or 5 different parameters per scene, and it's much better to do it in such a table, including any time adjustments and selections on off and so on. So a small further, let me say, optimization, let's say, in the new ETS version. Yeah, then we come to so-called output names inside the ETS application as well. What does it mean for each output? Let's take switch actuator A. I can assign a name, a description, a designation inside the parameter window, and automatically this name, this item will be forwarded to the headline here of this parameter block. Also here it will be shown to select the different parameter parts, and each group object related to this output gets also this name, in addition to what it is, switching status and so on. So practically also here a better overview in the ETS, especially if you assign later the group addresses to the objects. Yeah. Makes it much easier to find the right object here if you have the real load name also in the group object view visible. Yeah. So that's then easily or much easier possible. A small note in this regard, status today or December 2021, it's existing at the moment for the standard and professional range of our switch actuators, but not yet implemented for the combi switch actuator, but will come. Challenge here is we have in the combi switch actuator not only switching, you remember, also shutter, makes it a bit more complex to implement this, but our guys in the R&D department are working on this and will come. Good. These were in principle the smaller or more bigger changes in the application 1.1. But I have some more information for you. And so what did we do practically with the new ETS application? Yeah, all switch actuators are, let me say, unified now in wording. So also some internal texts have been adapted, optimized a bit. So for all the same. And you might find here and there some changes in the parameters and wording, but in functions not different, except these additional features I have just mentioned. ETS application 1.1, when available in the next days, so not very far anymore. And we have also a new firmware besides the ETS application. Remember, sometimes in a component, we offer you or we have to have a new firmware, and also for our three subtypes of the switch actuators, we have now new firmware version available, also available in the next days. So, of course, it's recommended to update also firmware. It's not prerequisite for the new ETS application. It works also with the former one, but of course you should always update the firmware. And yeah, just for your information to do so, use our ETS app firmware update version 2.0. It replaces the ABB KNX bus update app, which did more or less the same firmware update, but it's optimized here. I give you a short hint how it works. So this is a way to update the firmware. Yeah, if you would like to update the application, of course you can import your application in the ETS, and if you create a new project, you take the new application. Nothing new for you. If you have already an existing project with existing switch actuators and application version 1.0, then it's nice to update also the application, but not to delete all the parameters and to delete all the group objects or group addresses into group objects. With our app update copy convert new version, also 1.0.160, you can do this easily. Also here you get some information. Yeah. So if not in your ETS, go to the shop, knx.org, and to the shop and take these apps free of charge. Import this. If you have it already, it's also possible to update your apps. Very simple. You have to click here in the ETS under the apps on this round arrow, and it checks for update. Then you get the information for this and this app is an update available. Then you confirm, and then automatically your app will be also updated if already existing your ETS. Yeah, and what else might be interesting for some of you, the product manual and also technical data are now for our switch actuators also available in all the 8 languages we normally have for our components, not only German and English, but all the others you see here, and also available in the next days. So not very far anymore. Yeah, this firmware update, a short hint how it works. Takes this new firmware update app 2.0, either from the shop, knx.org, or if you haven't already updated it, if needed. So that's very easy to carry out this firmware update. So what do you do if you have it integrated in your ETS? You click here on top of the ETS under apps on this dedicated app. You activate it, then this window will be open, the next one. Then you can select also the device type here. And if you say, okay, I have 5 switch actuator combi here in my project, you click here only on device type SAH/S, and then all components in your project with as combi actuators will be shown here with the current firmware you have at the moment. And as the firmware update takes directly from our data server the new firmware version, you don't have to import anything. You don't have only a look, oh, there's an update available status. And then you activate what you would like to update here, and then you click here, update firmware here in the middle. And then it takes a bit time to do so. You see a running slider here showing the progress. And finally, your firmware update should be completed. You can click also if you have many components on many of these devices, so then it will be done one after another. And but finally, the same result. It's very similar to the bus update app we had before, but yes, I think since spring this year we have this firmware update app 2.0, and some options you have here. For example, you can also force to downgrade the firmware to an older version. It's also possible in some special cases via options here. Yes, options. You can also import, if needed in special cases, firmware files, but normally in the practice you don't have to do, because it takes directly from our server the actual firmware version. So not difficult, but really recommended to do. Yeah, and this application update by means of this ABB app update copy convert. It's a very powerful app, not only updating the application, can do more, I come to this. You can do this application update. Yeah. So practically you have a project with 1.0 application already inside, with many products maybe you would like to update, but not starting from the scratch again to program everything again or parameterize everything again. So what do? You have to insert in your project only from this device you use a product with the actual application version 1.1. So this you have to add, because from this you copy then later the new application into your other components. But finally, you do the same as before. You select here the other app, update, copy, convert. Then the products will be shown here. Then select the device as well and click on update. And then it gives you the option from which device you would like to update, from which original device. And you see here, it's a device version 1.1. It's small but visible. I have insert additionally. And here, this product with 1.0, I would like to update without losing my parameterization and without losing already allocated group addresses. That's a big advantage here. So finally, you have not much work to update your product, but no changes in the product parameterization itself. Of course, if you have done so, you have to have a download, yeah, because the application is different and has to be downloaded. But this can be also optimized by selecting many components, and then it's done as well. So finally, you click here on Start Update, and does not take so much time, and then it's done, also for many components. Also here exists a learning session on a webinar. It was in 2019 about various software tools from ABB for KNX, talking exactly about these apps. And this webinar is only talking about the bus update app, but it's like the firmware update app we have right now, not really different, but we talk also about this one here, the update copy convert app here in this webinar. Yeah, to this app, as mentioned already, is also a new version now available, but this is already available, so you can update it if you have it already or take it from the shop, knx.org. So what did we do here in the update of this update copy convert app? There are two principles available for ABB and Bugega, but if you have one of these apps, you can update both KNX, Bushjega and ABB KNX devices. Yeah, so it's no different anymore. You don't need both versions here on your PC. One is sufficient. Yeah, and it supports, is very important here with a new application, also our switch actuator. So without this updated app, you cannot get no support for our switch actuators with a new ETS application 1.1. That's also important. Yeah. Always some improvements are done, wording, whatever, and this is in the background more. Also here a note you should take into account status today or this month. At the moment, a combi switch actuator cannot be converted to a standard professional version. Converting, I come to this in the next slides, what does it mean? Very nice feature to convert. You see here, in principle, you can convert from a combi switch actuator to a professional, of course, only on this level where the parameters are in compliance. Yeah, but also here you can save a lot of time and using such an convert function in the app. But I have in the next final slide some nice explanations around this. So very nice and important app we offer you to do different things together with our KNX devices in the ETS to save time and to have life easier, let's say. Yeah, let's go to this. This one comes from my colleague Carolina. She has made here a small summary, also with videos I would like to show. Just the overview of the four functions we have in this update copy convert app. Update we have learned already. ETS application update or downgrade is also possible. You can say, no, I had 1.1, I would like to have 1.0 again for my switch actuator. It's feasible to do, yeah, also here existing. This convert, transfer configuration from a source device to a destination device. Quite nice, already a bit mentioned. Copy exchange of outputs means if I have an output of a multi-channel device, I would like to copy this parameterization to other outputs in the same device. It's easily possible with this feature. Also exchanging of outputs is possible. Yeah, and the configuration you have done for a product, you can export and import here this to a further device, again, to save time in parameterization. So I would like to show you a very short, small videos about these features a bit. To do so, I have to change now to my screen. Not directly here in the WebEx environment, I can show videos. The update functions, in principle, I've shown to you already. The update from 1.4 to 2.0, it's a DALI gateway here, but same principle. And it's doing it with both devices, so not only one, but also the other one. So two devices were updated, and that's all. This is very simple, not really complicated. So an example here, why does it make sense? For example, Integrator has configured 15 ABB switch actuator standard with 1.0 application, and he got now the information, new version is available, and he would like to integrate it in energy or load management. Load shedding, remember what to do, only updating via the app. Not a big work. Also, you can select on all 15 devices at the same time, and finally you have done. And of course, then you have to add still maybe the group address to this new object which appears, because we have load shedding now available, that is clear, and a download of the devices. But I think for an additional feature, not that much work and not that much time. Next feature is convert. I start the video here as well. Converting transfer configuration from a source device to a destination device. So convert, we have your device here. So what do you want to do? This device, this group addresses you would like to convert. You see a source device is a 2-fold and destination device is a 12-fold device. You can convert from a device with less channels to a component with more channels. Of course, only the two channels you had originally, not more. The other 10 channels are free, outputs are free then, but can be used in addition. So if you need more channels, you replace the device, but still use the parameterization programming from the original components with a few outputs only. So between different components you can convert. Of course, the same type only, switch actuators, not to complete other devices, but also here quite useful. Okay, I think this we had already, I can jump over this, sorry, yeah. Also here a practical example, system integrator Anna configured all switch actuators 12-volt on floor 1 and 2 of a new Safari marketing headquarter. To keep track of energy consumption on the top floor, it was decided to install 12-volt switch actuators as well, but with energy functions, 6. You see here, different from the former one, 5 to 6 is energy functions. Instead of configuring the SAS with the energy functions from the scratch, the configuration already available from the lower floors can be easily transferred via our update copy convert app, and only the additional parameters need to be manually configured. Also here, time saving is a topic. Yeah, and last but not least, this copy exchange function inside this app. What does it mean? Let's have a look to the video. Means we take our device, we copy channels in the device. It's a 4-fold valve drive controller. We have programmed already channel A and would like to copy it to the other 3 channels in the same device, including group addresses. And just start it. So you copy the parameterization only. Okay, you can work also with templates to remember this, but also a further option. So this is copy and exchange, very similar. Just take in a one device a channel and exchange it with another channel. Maybe due to wrong installation, wiring or whatever, you have to do this. Channel C and D are exchanged now, including group addresses. And after a few clicks, your job is done. I really like this app and useful and with different features. So also here an example, what does it mean? But I think you have seen what are the advantages here. Export. Export input is really the final one. You see it's not finalized up to now. So export configuration to import it into another device. So we have here maybe 20 valve drive controller. We have to copy more or less only in configuration. We need this many times, so we copy it to a file, export it, and then we import this to our further new components by using the same export file we have just done. Okay, so and import, and then it's also done. This is not very time consuming and quickly done. So, okay, now takes, oh no, it's completed. Good. Also here, I think it's clear what's behind. I don't want to go into details here. Okay. Not only valid for, of course, our switch actuators, but I think it fits quite well here. And if you get confused about all our additional tools we have, I added here a further slide to give you more more information about all our tools, not in details. Don't worry. I just want to show you only a tooling overview. In principle, some pages, but you get access to this very simple via this link tooling overview from our to our homepage. But of course, you get all these presentation and you can go there then directly. And this tooling overview gives you information of all our tools we have, not only about KNX, but also Free at Home, but mainly about KNX, and split into four parts. ETS apps, we just were talking about, like the firmware app. Mobile apps, think about the app from our Control Touch for remote control of your building. Service tools, here our famous ABB IMAS tool is of course integrated or visible, and we have additional configurators. Think about our ABB Tacteo configurator, where you can create your own glass switch or glass switch, KNX switch, with this configurator, and some more inside, and all visible here in this tooling overview. So I come now to my final slides. Also something not only related to our switch actuators, but as we support this now with our switch actuator, I would like to explain what's behind. Bus key, sorry, BCU key, BCU, bus coupler unit key. BCU key is a feature inside the ETS and not new, allowing you to set a key for programming actuator, not actuator, KNX devices, inside this project. So it's a project key, and all products, KNX products, inside this project, which supports this BCU key, not all do this, can then be locked via this key. So nobody can program the application without this key. You just lock the device, and to do the download, you need always a key. Or not only the key, but also the original ETS project allows you to do this as well. So you, as the system integrator commissioning the components, you have the project, the initial project, you set a key, and you know, okay, ABB switch actuator can handle this, so nobody can reprogram these devices with any external project where it only accesses this device and tries to download the application. It's not possible. Yeah. So either the key is always needed, or if you have the original project, then it's also okay. Yeah, you can also export your project from your ETS and give it later to your customer. And also this project then contains this key directly. You don't have to add this. But again, if an unauthorized person gets access to the installation, knows also as a switch actuator combi, SAHS from ABB 24 channels, he inserted in his project and tries to access his device and would like to download this with another application, not possible without the key. So advantage, unauthorized programming, reprogramming is not possible without the key or original ETS project. Of course, there's also a risk. Well, in case of lost key or lost original ETS project, the device can be used only with the actual programming and commissioning status. You cannot change it anymore. So any changes are not possible and without the key. And you have no other chance. You have, without the key, no chance, or the original project, to get access to the product. So finally, you need a new product in such a case. Just to show what is possible, chances and risk, and our switch actuators supports this. So the SAS and SHAS have this BCU key active, let's say, and you can use it. Yeah? And you see here what happens with the key, no problem. You get successfully the download. And if you don't have the key or you don't have the original ETS project, a failure message will appear if you try to download the applications, only for the application. Of course, for our products, you find everything on our homepage, also here. And very soon, also the new ETS application. But if you use the online catalog inside the ETS, it will be there also available directly. So further tool, small tool, also in the tooling overview, relatively new. Therefore, we would like to show it here quickly. Software repository is nothing else but an Excel sheet on our homepage, giving you access the easy way to any ETS application from new or old products in the KNX world from ABB. Here's this Excel sheet. You go to search criteria and type in the type, the name of the components, the type of the components, and then all existing older and newer one, also new applications, ETS applications will be shown here. So you have easily access also to old applications if needed, or to products which are not available anymore. Yeah, our training database, you know, where you have everything. Of course, also this will be then stored there. But you get a feedback email, of course, where you get also links to this presentation and video from today. Light on Building next year, 13th to 18th of March. We are still very optimistic that it can take place, maybe slightly adapted, let's say. But in Germany, the situation with Corona is quite stable at the moment. And let's see what happens. We keep you informed whatever happens. Yeah, further webinars, learning sessions not yet planned. This was the final one this year, this webinar. But of course, we continue with webinars online and practical learning sessions. No problem. But wait for next year. Yeah, and as the year is going and the new one is coming, here my real last slide. First of all, thank you to all of you who participated in all our sessions over the year. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, and let's come together in the next year again, of course, online always, but hopefully also very soon face to face. Okay, let's see, let's be optimistic, and maybe with a mask, no problem, yeah, but with the option that you can also sit in the room in our training rooms worldwide. Again, I keep the chat still a bit open. I say thank you for your participation all the time, and especially today. See you next year. Bye-bye. Ciao.